Both my girls head to toe designer. Designer. Drip. Little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. West LA, that where you find me though. Cha-cha macho with a rockin' black clothes. Whip around that Batmobile, duckin' 5-0. If you step to me, then be prepared for smoke, lil' bro. Let me feel myself a little bit. Let me blow this down.
Today, from Orchard Park, New York, this is the NFL on EA Sports. Allen and the Buffalo Bills taking on Philip Rivers and the Indianapolis Colts.
And we are underway in Buffalo. Andre Roberts now to return it. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. Out comes the offense for the Bills, led by their quarterback at 6'5". That's Josh Allen.
How about 54 touchdown passes in two full seasons at the University of Wyoming? Coming out of a junior college, I think he exceeded expectations, and he can move it around a little bit, too. A much better athlete than people give him credit for.
Now the first carry for Devin Singletary. He'll wind up getting a yard on the game's first play at second down.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
He'll have a first down past the 40. And he'll get this all the way up to the 42-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. Josh Allen, he says that he wants to continue to perfect executing the run-pass option. Looked pretty good there.
And he's put in the minds of all people trying to defend him that his legs create big plays. So guess who benefits?
His running back.
You no doubt about it, and we just saw it there.
Yeah, the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. Xavier Rhodes, the cornerback, there in coverage.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. They get six. That'll leave him with third and four.
One thing we do know, he's going to get his catches. So as they move forward defensively, got to continue to focus on not giving up the big play when he does catch the ball in the secondary.
They face a third and four after that last completion gets him six. So the shotgun snap to Allen. And that's caught by Beasley. And he is going to have a Bills first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven. Allen to Beasley, first down Buffalo. Now Allen again. On the left side, he finds Beasley. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Right back to him for 10 more and a first. So from the 36 now, first and 10. And he's already got two catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball. And sometimes it just happens naturally. And then you change your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going back to him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
Brings up second and nine.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Give him 6 yards on the carry. It's going to be third and three now.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Brings up third and three.
Eighth play of this opening drive coming up. This is third down.
58, right over there, right over there. Yeah.
Working out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. And he's able to find Diggs. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Allen to Diggs there for a Buffalo first. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far in the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
Operating from the red zone now, Allen. Allen hit. He lost the football. And the Colts pick it up. He's at the 50. He's at the 40. 20. 10. And they are going to score on the fumble return. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Big boy earning his lunch. That's what you call rumbling with the ball, Charles.
Big man with football. He wasn't just earning lunch, Brandon. He was earning dinner. He was
midnight snack.
Everything that you could possibly do, he did it on that play to pick up the ball and go.
Now they'll line up to kick the extra point. And this is good to make it 7-0 Indy. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six.
Rigoberto Sanchez.
So here's the kickoff now as they'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. Here's the all-pro returner from 2018, Andre Roberts. And able to get this out to the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
So here come the Bills out for their second drive. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line.
54.
Off play action, he'll throw to start the drive. Under pressure, and they got to him again. A man who has done this a lot, Justin Houston, in there to record the sack. Defensive end gets in there that time. They were in a 4-3. What's the responsibility of the ends versus the tackles there, Charles?
Well, most of the time, when you talk about the ends, they're your pass rushers. They're the guys that you turn loose to try and get to the guy who's going to throw the football. The tackles, usually more of the run-stuffing variety. But the way this game is advanced, you're wanting a little bit of everything out of all of your guys. But let's just go ahead and break it down and make it simple. The guy who's the right defensive end versus a right-handed quarterback, that's the blind side. He's going after the quarterback. He's going to put him on the ground.
For the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down. Now Allen off the bootleg. He finds a man with a crossing route. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Colts 7, Bills nothing.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Midfield to the 48-yard line. It's a gain of 7. Brings up second and 3.
Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Stephon Diggs, his intended receiver, and it's third and short.
In any event, it happened pretty quickly. I'm not sure he made the right decision on that one. I think if he had it to do over again, he would have found a different target downfield. But he made his decision, and that one's incomplete.
Allen going to try and throw on third down. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he is going to have a Bills first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards.
26-yard line.
On first down, Singletary. And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough and run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
Throwing on second down, Allen. And that'll be incomplete. Allen's took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
And I think they'd be well served to take that type of a physical approach against him the rest of the game. He's had his way so far, but on that last one, that worked quite well for the defense.
The Bills on third down, a perfect 4-for-4 thus far. This is third and 10. Allen gonna throw. Pressure applied, and he's gonna be taken down. They sack him back at the 33-yard line. In on the sack, the former Buckeye, Tyquan Lewis.
I'm starting to feel for that quarterback back there. I mean, you know me. Normally, don't have a lot of empathy for the QB, right? In this case, definitely. He's been under constant duress this entire game. I don't know how he's surviving back there.
And to think, there's still a long way to go in this football game.
Makes the score Colts 7, Bills 3.
These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny, when we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
First and 10.
Colts ready to go to work here offensively, and it is Phillip Rivers, their veteran quarterback and longtime Charger, who will be under center.
One way you become the all-time leading passer for your team is pure talent, and Phillip Rivers has plenty of that. But it's also dedication to your craft and the willingness to get better all the time. Phillip Rivers has a van set up with a driver so that when he goes to and from practice, he's able to watch tape and find ways to improve his mechanics each and every day.
And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4.
He's tackled.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
It's on the pickup. Second and 6.
Working out of the gun, Rivers. He'll find Hines out of the backfield.
Rivers.
That's a good job there by the corner. We do talk about this a lot, that a lot of corners see their job as simply covering receivers. Tackling isn't everyone's thing. But in this case, he came up quickly and made a nice, sure tackle.
And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
Important to do, especially early in the game like they have. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
Have to give some credit to the defender on that when he read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
He rifles one that's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 46. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it completed in this case.
Coming out with a jumbo package to start the drive. So after the INT, it's Allen. He's got it complete to Diggs, right side. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 25 yards that time. Back in the first quarter, you said it. They need to avoid the big play, but he just got a big one right there.
You can't relax. You know, we talked about in the first quarter, but as the game progresses, still opportunities, and he took advantage of one there.
And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Give the tackle to Anthony Walker.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. On second and nine, Allen. He'll be hit and taken down at the 21.
The quarterback.
And on that one, the protection just broke down.
You've got to have that leverage, don't you? We always talk about low man wins in the running game for an offensive lineman versus a defensive lineman. It's essentially the same thing in pass protection. Get lower than that defensive lineman so that you can keep your balance and keep him away from your guy trying to throw the football.
And that is caught. Touchdown, Buffalo. Cole Beasley there to make the grab. And the Bills have taken the lead. That could be an important swing right there. A touchdown in the final minute of the half to take the lead.
And I like the point you just made there. Could be an important swing because now that they have the lead, if they can carry that into the locker room at the half, they'll feel really good about what they accomplished in the first two quarters.
A try here for the extra point. And it's through, and that makes the lead 10-7. A drive there of just four plays. And it culminates in a Bills touchdown. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line.
The Colts take over first and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
Phillip Rivers now gears up to take the offense back out there. He's likely still kicking himself from the interception last drive that wound up leading to a go-ahead score.
And he's going to assume all that came with that one, all right? That's all on him. But he also knows he's got to erase it from his mind and get back out there. This drive, very important.
He was looking for Jack Doyle that time. And now it's second down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target. But he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Not wanting to take a chance this time, they'll keep it on the ground. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. So first and 10 now from the 30. From the shotgun, it's Rivers. Over the middle here, it's Hilton. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. Rivers on first down. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's second and 10. From the gun, Rivers. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock.
He was looking for Michael Pittman that time.
And now it's third down. And the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. Final play of the half, Rivers. He'll take a shot downfield for Pittman. And unable to connect, incomplete. I'll give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. as we'll send you down to Orlando and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
His guys lead, though by only a field goal. Still anybody's game. As we send it back to Brandon Godden and Charles.
Tyler Bass to kick off for Buffalo.
The Colts getting the football first, and they trail here as we are back underway in quarter number three. Rodgers on the return. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
Isaiah Rodgers on the return. The Colts take over first and 10.
Out come the Colts. They'll have it first here to start quarter number three. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. They begin the drive with Hines. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to second and 4.
Well, I think after that run, the defense getting back in the huddle and looking at each other and maybe starting to question their confidence a bit. They gave up a significant run, 6 yards, and now you're saying to yourself, how do we stop them, and do I have enough confidence to make a play?
Off the play fake here, Rivers. And they take him down. The Bills get to him. Jerry Hughes, what a play by him. That's going to go as a loss of 13. Impressive individual effort there. No one was going to stop him around the edge.
Yeah, no doubt about it. And that's why if you play in a 4-3 base and you're a defensive end, that's why you get the big bucks. They count on you to do everything. Defend the run and, of course, get to the quarterback.
And that sack leaves Rivers and the Colts with a 3rd and long. From the gun, Rivers. He's got Jack Doyle. And down he'll go at the 25. Just a 5-yard pickup, but it leads to 4th down.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of the 1st down.
Nice punt, but good work on the return to get back 11 yards. And the Bills will take over the football with a 1st and 10. Here comes Josh Allen and the Bills' offense back onto the field. He's playing pretty well. I don't think it's necessarily him changing up something. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week on our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to, and if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. On 2nd and 1, Allen, he'll let this go for the end zone. And this is caught for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs, 46 yards. And the Bills will add on to their lead. Well, you know he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. But sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. And that's almost like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go long,
backyard.
Man. I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Extra point splits the uprights, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Rodgers on the return. And up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
The Colts take over first and 10 at their own.
The Colts set to take over here offensively.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Hines, and he's dropped right at the 40, gain of 3.
You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making
it. Now the ball's out, fumble near midfield. Now this is picked up by the Bills, and his guys are going to take over at their own 48-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
The football back to the Bills and Stephon Diggs.
And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
Tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. A gain of 11 that time, and a Colts first down.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
They run with Hines. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
No gain on the play. Brings up second and 10.
Looking to throw on second down. Rivers. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
An important play right here, third and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On third down, Rivers taken in by the tight end, Doyle. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Give the Colts 13 yards and a first down.
The Colts first down.
Now it's Hines. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. A gain of 3, second down. Second and 7. 3 quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and 6. No, scratch that. Second and 7. They stay on the ground again. It's Hines. And he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about 4 to go.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
On third down, Hines. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. 3 plays, all resulting in 3-yard carries to bring up fourth down.
So many things going to making a good play on defense. In this situation, just not being blown out of the way was a big start, and then a nice tackle to finish things off.
Blankenship's kick is good. And they're back within a touchdown. It's 17-10. All right, so they needed two scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
And there's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a three and out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
On the return, the Bills take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
Now the Bills' offense gets ready to head back onto the field. They've been rolling the last couple of drives, each ending in touchdowns. So this game is flipped. They were down, now they're up with the football. We'll see how they handle it.
Can we get a spy on the headset now between the head coach and offensive coordinator? Because they've been in attack mode, had to get back into the game. Now they have the lead. Do you stay on the attack, or do you dial it back a little bit to try and protect this lead?
Well, my cop-out answer would be somewhere in the middle. I think it's going to be a fine line, is it not?
I think you're exactly right, but I do think if they can stay aggressive and keep them on their heels, they'll be best served that way.
Give them a couple on the carry there, second and eight.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and eight.
A play fake to Singletary, and now it's Allen. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Normally being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
Eluding the pressure right. He can run for it, and he will. Now he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. If he needs to make those plays with the legs, go ahead, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. It's, at this stage of the game, all protections, they're off.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone and nearly picked it off. He had a chance to come down with that in the end zone, but it'll wind up just being incomplete.
He was defended by Julian Blackmon.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up.
All right, that's a decent game there, but it hasn't been his best game overall. So I wonder what the mindset is of his team. Do they want him to handle the football and try and close this game out? Or are they going to make an alternative plan and maybe go in a different direction?
I think they need him, and this is his time to shine. Third down, here's a run by Moss. And this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Makes the score Bills 20, Colts 10.
So his second field goal of the game, and that could turn out to be the big one.
Yeah, you have to make him score twice to beat you, and that's not impossible. But here in the fourth quarter, puts their backs clearly against the wall.
So after knocking through the field goal, here's Bass to kick it away. Rodgers on the return. And they will wrangle it down a couple yards shy of the 30.
On the return, the Colts take over first and 10. At their own 28.
So now the veteran Rivers and the Colts down 20-10. A little under 2.5 to go. It's been a struggle to score all day, and now they need to do it twice here late to have a chance. A good start to the drive here. That's caught out on the left side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
A gain of 15.
15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So the Colts in possession of the football as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. A good throw here, finding Pascal.
Rivers.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. And right now, defensively, you love that, don't you? And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now Rivers. And Pascal's got it. And he is going to have a Colts first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. He was looking for his running back, Nyheim Hines. And it's second down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
Rivers to throw. And he comes back with one complete. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. And that is incomplete.
Rivers pass intended for Nyheim Hines. Incomplete.
He did a fine job there not hitting him before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here.
A 32-yard attempt.
Blankenship's kick is good. But wait up now, a flag is down. If this is on the defense, they're going to get the first. So they elect to decline it.
And why not? Just go ahead and let the play stand, and they'll take that.
That penalty is declined.
So with under 30 seconds to play, this is the game right here. And this is going to be recovered by the Bills, and that should all but do it. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get him.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. The Bills on their way to victory now as they take the knee. Now the Colts will use their 3rd and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go in the football game. The first down line at the 34 here on 3rd down. They'll toss this right side to Singletary. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. 6 yards in the wrong direction that time. Not only that, but it brings up 4th. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left.
The Bills send the punter out, as he should be able to pin him back deep here with his first punt. And how about this, a fake? But he will not make the first down marker. That'll be a turnover on downs.
Today's final score, Bills.
But Charles, a one-score game. Down to the end we went. They had one final play in that one-score game. We all knew what was coming, the Hail Mary. They just couldn't get it done.
What exactly complicated was it? We all knew, as you said, and go long and see if we can find someone open. They didn't get it done. Someone's happy. Someone is not.
That's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com.